Hello, Seiiti Arata. Let's take a moment to look back at our lives and see how much we have changed. We can start on a scale of decades. 3 decades ago, what was going on in your life? Let me show you how I do this exercise, so then you can also do it on your side. For me, 3 decades ago, I used to love so many silly things. It was great to be a child in a world that was a giant playground. I could play without any serious consequences. 2 decades ago, while I was a teenager with lots of immature fears and wants, I innocently thought I was already a grown-up who had an answer for everything. 1 decade ago, I was lonely, insecure, and struggling to find love. I had advanced professionally and intellectually, but I was lagging behind emotionally. I got drunk so many times and got into embarrassing situations. It was a time for a lot of change. Well, that was life on the scale of decades. 3 decades, 2 decades, 1 decade. I'm wondering how this was for you. If you feel comfortable, you can share with us using the comments below how you have changed. Perhaps sharing different photographs from each decade. But what about in terms of years? What was going on with you 3 years ago? 3 years ago, I was working with the United Nations office in Geneva and was also advancing my studies about human behavior and coaching. And this is when I learned that our behavior is influenced by triggers. I realized that the way to promote positive change is not to use some violent language and criticism towards bad behavior. Instead, we should provide resources to encourage alternative good behavior. And this made me so excited that I wanted to share it with everybody. However, the way I was doing it was to impose my right ideas into other people's wrong ones. And today I see that this was very immature, but that was the best I could do back then. 2 years ago, my business, Arata Academy, got a bigger audience, so I decided to leave the United Nations and be fully dedicated to producing our training programs. And this also changed me in so many ways, since by making my work widely available, I received a lot of feedback, which I used to keep improving. And my biggest lesson so far came about 1 year ago. I came to realize that because of my personality and because of my work, I had this tendency to listen very hard to people, to feel their pain, to suffer from their problems. And that was causing me a lot of harm. I was always listening with the intention of finding a solution, but sometimes the people talking to me just wanted to be understood. As I rushed to offer some strategy, some book recommendation, some coaching technique, I would lose my connection. And then I would feel that these people were not grateful for me for trying so hard to offer my help. See, this realization was also a big change for me, and since then I have become better able to relate to people, to have empathy, to respect them as they are. So here you go. When I look at how I change, I particularly like to pay attention to how my worldview changes, how I relate to people in a different way, what is improving, and what's starting to go to a direction that I'm not very proud of. All this provides me feedback to continue to change over the next years in a way that feels more fulfilling. If you want to share this video with your friends in other languages, you can visit arata.se/seiiti03. Cheers, hasta luego, un forte abraço. So what about you? I wonder what valuable lessons you can learn from this exercise. Can you see yourself in a different way? Take a moment to think how you can use this to shape your future. And then, next week, we will see how important it is to understand our changes so we don't get labeled. Subscribe to this channel so then you don't miss anything.